Many of us drive over our local railways each day without giving them a second thought. But the railroads in our state actually have a rich history and are the subject of a new book, Railroads of Rhode Island. And local author Frank Heppner joins us this morning. Good morning. Thanks for being here with us.
Well, thank you very much.
This is a great book. You know, I was looking through the book before the, before the interview and going over it. What made you want to write about this?
Well, I've been interested in railroads ever since I was a baby. I was actually kind of born to it. My dad was a doctor who worked for the Southern Pacific Railroad, and I had my first train ride at 3, and I was traveling around the country by myself on trains when I was 16. So it was kind of a natural thing. I'm retired now from URI. Why not a book about railroads of Rhode Island?
Right. You know, and as looking through this book, many people don't realize without the railroad what an impact the railroad had on our little state of Rhode Island.
Oh, absolutely. We wouldn't be the state that we are today without the introduction of the railroads that first came in 1835. And the state's been totally dependent on railroads ever since. What we see now is Amtrak and the commuter trains, but we also have a going freight railroad concern that nobody ever sees because it goes from Quonset all the way up to Woonsocket. But the state does a lot of business through the existing railroads.
Now, is that the Providence-Worcester Railroad that goes through?
That's the Providence-Worcester Railroad, yes.
Okay, there's a lot of us see on 95. You can look over and see it on
the highway. You can see those cars,
yeah. Right. The other thing I was looking through, the pictures that you've acquired to put in this book are amazing.
Well, I lucked out. I found a retired banker from Rhode Island who had a wonderful collection of old postcards and pictures that he'd picked up from flea markets. And I contacted him and he said, oh, sure, yeah, use all the pictures that you want. So they're not really my pictures, but it's wonderful that they've been preserved the way they have.
And one of the pictures that's, you know, fascinating to me is the picture in downtown Providence. The tunnels that the buses use now to go from the east side to downtown were once for trolleys.
That's correct. They were for trolley cars, and there was another tunnel, which people are not usually aware of, that was for commuter trains from Bristol and Warren. And these trains came up the east side and then crossed over the old bridge that you can still see the bridge is stuck in the up position. They went across that bridge into the east side tunnel and then directly to downtown Providence. So 70 years ago, instead of fighting all the traffic on 195, you could get on a very comfortable electric train and come into downtown Providence.
And tell everybody about the book signing you've got coming up tomorrow.
Oh, I'm going to be going up to the Brown Bookstore at 5:30. I'm going to give a little slideshow on the railroads of Rhode Island, and then afterwards I'll be available for answering questions.
All right, the question I have, and I asked you this morning, I have driven over that Washington Bridge thousands of times in, you know, East Providence to Providence, and you look over and all you can see is that railroad bridge up. What is the deal with that thing? It's been like that ever since I was little.
That was the bridge that connected the East Side Railroads, the Providence, Warren, and Bristol, with a connection to Fall River, to Providence. So the railroads went up under what today is 195, and then curved over, went over that bridge, and then into the East Side Tunnel. The bridge has been left in place for legal reasons, and it's still available if they ever wanted to restore that service again.
Really?
So it's up to the desires of the people.
To get it back in action again.
That's right.
All right, so book signing tomorrow. What time is it again?
Be 5:30 in the afternoon.
5:30, Brown Bookstore.
Brown Bookstore, yes.
Thank you so much for coming in. Really interesting stuff. And the book is Railways of Rhode Island. And for more information on tomorrow's book signing, you can head to our website, WPRI.com.